New York-based Shen Yun is now in its 12th year of touring the world. The company gave the audiences at the Kennedy Center Opera House in Washington, D.C. an 8-performance run this year, from April 10th to 15th.
This was the first time I've really learned very much about Chinese culture, and it was wonderful to learn, but the dances were just magnificent. I loved the way the dancers could use the costume sort of almost as an extension of their body. I thought that was quite wonderful.
I enjoyed the athleticism of the dancers, the choreography, and the music. It was very entertaining. I enjoyed it very much.
Tickets for the 7 originally scheduled shows were sold out, and so an extra show was added for Sunday night. According to its website, the 2-hour Shen Yun performance consists of about 20 pieces, moving from one story, region, and dynasty to the next.
And I'm especially glad to see the acknowledgement of other ethnic groups in China. I especially enjoyed the Hmong dance and the Mongolian chopstick dance. It was very charming and very refreshing.
It was absolutely wonderful. Not only was the dancing and the costumes absolutely beautiful, but it really was very, very inspiring to be able to listen to some of the stories that were told through dance.
China's 5,000-year-old history is filled with legends of people becoming enlightened or obtaining the Tao through self-cultivation, cultivation of one's moral character. Taoist thought is as old as Chinese culture itself. The systemization was carried out by the sage Laozi, who wrote the Tao Te Ching in 500 BC.
And I think this show brings it forward, a moral and spiritual element in our daily lives, in a very real way.
I think that it is something that every Chinese person, every Chinese American, and every American just in general can be so proud that such a wonderful performance. This is something I think that everyone should see to gain an appreciation for the history, the beauty of Chinese culture, dance, and music.
But in 1949, the Communist Party seized power and began to systematically destroy the ancient Chinese culture. They broke down the Chung Hwa Monument in Confucius's mansion, the equivalent of tearing down the Washington Monument in Washington, D.C.
That it would be very important for more Americans to see this kind of show, to be able to understand the kind of change that occurred in China with the onset of the Communist regime in 1949, and how that has the Communist regime so radically tried to change Chinese culture.
And I think that helped to remind those of us who, only very often, quite frankly, only know the negative aspects of what is happening in China and don't have an appreciation for what was in China, the culture and the beauty that unfortunately at one time was lost. And through this program, that is being brought to life again.
NTD News, Washington, D.C.